I want to talk about the EPA, the pick for EPA, Scott Pruitt. But first, the Rockefeller family announced they are divesting themselves of all their holdings in Exxon. Tell my audience why they're divesting themselves of their holdings, and they'll better understand Scott Pruitt.
Some of the hot water that I talked about earlier that they've been in for denying climate change, science, and kind of hiding the fact that they knew, that they've known about the dangers of climate change for years and have been hiding that, are some of the reasons that I think they are divesting, is they don't want to be associated with that kind of name and that those issues there. They've had some kind of publicly, they've said that they, you know, would support the Paris Climate Agreement, things like that, that they, the company believes that climate change is real, but, you know, more secretively and covertly, really, they've been funding climate science denial groups and different scientists, contrarian scientists, that will basically say that the dangers aren't real and that it's not happening. And so that's not something that big names like the Rockefellers want to be associated with.
Yeah, I read their letter. The Rockefeller family wrote an official letter. It was published in the New York Review of Books. One of the things I came to understand is that Exxon Mobil, for the past 40 years, hired the top climate scientists in the world. You know, you always think NASA has the top climate scientists, but it was really Exxon. And about 40 years ago, they realized they were heating up the planet and knew there was a problem. And like the cigarette companies, they chose to bury that information. And the Rockefeller family, is their fortune was built from ExxonMobil, and they're walking away from it. You're listening to Highlights from the David Feldman Show, heard nationwide on Pacifica Radio, or as a podcast on iTunes, Stitcher, and now YouTube. Please subscribe to this channel. For more information, go to davidfeldmanshow.com. Thank you for listening.
The David Feldman Radio Program is made possible by listeners like you. You sad, pathetic humps.